In the morning, in brilliant sunshine, the Emperor and the Empress leave the palace. They are on their way to the Jubilee Mass in St. George's Church, where Haile Selassie I was crowned Emperor in 1930. Haile Selassie I.
Sahara Hat, Emerald Music Incorporated, that's Sinai Rastafari Brethren, is for them in truth. So, Twist Womb, Tawahido 1000. And let's begin, Besamea for Wethum and Cheskebums, Ahadum Lai. For immediate release, October 1st, 1963, Office of the White House Press Secretary. The White House exchanged remarks between President John F. Kennedy and His Imperial Majesty, Haile Selassie I, Emperor of Ethiopia. Upon the latter's arrival, lower the music a little. Give thanks, President. Nice. For immediate release, October 1st, 1963, Office of the White House, Press Secretary of the White House. Exchange of remarks between President John F. Kennedy and His Imperial Majesty Haile Selassie I, Emperor of Ethiopia, upon the latter's arrival at the Union Station, Washington, D.C. So these are the words with which His Imperial Majesty was greeted by John F. Kennedy and his lovely wife 20 days before he was assassinated. November 20th, I believe, it's around that time, 50 days before. 50 days. His Majesty, I believe, arrived at the U.S. like October 1st, and anyways, President Kennedy, ladies and gentlemen, I know I speak on behalf of all my fellow Americans in welcoming His Imperial Majesty back to the United States. In welcoming His Majesty, we honor not only a distinguished leader of his country and a distinguished world figure, but we also welcome a man whose place in history is already assured. His memorable and distinctive appearance before the League of Nations in the mid-30s, which so stirred the conscience of the world, was supported prior to that by action, and has been supported in its in his high hopes by the consistent support which His Imperial Majesty has given to those efforts since the end of the Second World War to associate the free nations together in support of the most recent effort. I think I messed up, hold up. Together in common, and I'm gonna read that again, my bad. By the consistent support which His Imperial Majesty has given to those efforts since the end of the Second War to associate the free nations together in common enterprises, support to the effort in Korea, his support of the most recent effort in the Congo, the strong support he has given to the United States, and perhaps most celebrated of all, his leadership in building a community of free and independent states in Africa. Since His Imperial Majesty's visited the United States nearly a decade ago, we have seen one of the most extraordinary revolutions in history, and that has been the appearance on the world scene of 29 independent countries in the short space of less than 10 years, including over 150 million people. That means free, liberated from colonialism. The conference recently held in His Majesty's capital served, I think, to bring together in a great cooperative movement the people of most of these countries. And the success of that conference was due in no small part to the leadership of our distinguished guest. That's a reference to the Organization of African Union. Therefore, for what he has done in his own country, his efforts to move his country forward and to provide a better life for its people, and his efforts throughout the world, which stretch back over 30 or 40 years, for all of this, Your Majesty, we take the greatest pride in welcoming you here. You do us honor, and I can assure you that there is no guest that we will receive in this country that will give a greater sense of livelier pride and satisfaction to the American people than your presence here today. Your Majesty, you're most welcome.
Stop!
150 million liberated individuals as a result of 29 new nations in Africa.
That's it.
$150 million? Yeah, so do your research.
Tell them about it.
You know, this is blocked history, but they blocked history.
That's
YouTube
right.
It. Washington, D.C., the streets were crowded. There's parade, there's ceremony, there's marching bands, all in honor of this man, this black man, in a time when being black is inferior, said to have been inferior. Now, we don't know about that. That's because they blocked history. But it is our job to be the ones to inform the public with the necessary intelligence to make a reasonable, you know, decision as to how to act. So if many are wondering, Ethiopia to us represents a light in the darkness, because outside of Ethiopia we have no nationality. It's the only empire that has been independent for the past 5,000 plus years. And without it, black people all over the world do not have a claim to sovereignty as free individuals. So it means a lot to us. Ethiopia is the one place that the enemy was never able to colonize. It's a symbol of light, freedom, independence, not to mention a Judeo, then later converted Christian empire. So if you see the rainbow, that's because to Noah it was said that the rainbow would be a sign. And that banner represents that same sign. The other colors that are not visible in the spectrum are not necessary, because they attain to the spiritual, which is unseen. Anyways, we can't see past a certain degree of light. That's why the blue, violet, indigo, all that, they're not represented in the flag.
Ultraviolet, yes sir. Go on, Brendan.
Yes, I want to give thanks to Brother Alonso, right? The historian of our community. Can you give it up to the brother for his education and his dedication to His Majesty? So a lot of us would not have even been aware. We want to thank Most High for diversity. We want to thank Most High for the 12 tribes so that we can express ourselves in different ways and find the pieces of the puzzle that connects us together. And ones and ones, they have blocked our history. So we're asking everybody to come together, show their humanity, express themselves, get up on the mic. There's a sign up over there by the art table, Brother Alonso's artwork. Please feel free to sign up. We got Brother Shaka on the queue, so don't be so shy. We have a show for you. We're going to have some dancing at 4:30. Matt Ballin is here getting his gear together, right? Right? Also, another brother in the heart of this beautiful kingdom. The kingdom is here, and we're expressing it loud and clear, boldly. Don't hide. Don't be scared. We're a little thirsty. But be ready to drink up and block history, right? Thirsty for knowledge, thirsty for love, thirsty for manifesting who we are from above and here on earth and make it shine. So please get this mic off my hands, because I can really keep it going.
I guess it's important to mention. And these beats are actually kind of traditional Ethiopian music influence, but, you know, with hip-hop and reggae and all that kind of stuff, so they're really neat. In that same visit that His Majesty made in 1963, around the 6th or the 7th, he addressed the United Nations at the assembly in New York City, New York. And this whole block history thing is about a new race. A new race of people overcoming petty prejudices, owing our ultimate allegiance not to nations but to our fellow within the human community. The weapons to which man now toils with and plays with are their results are too destructive to answer the question whether who will rise victorious upon the next world war. The answer is no answer. The weapons we play with are too destructive for there to be a positive outcome. There will be no winner. It will be the annihilation of the human community. So to put aside local, personal, national interest aside and do what's right for the human community is our responsibility, in the which we would then become members of this new race, in the which we would owe our ultimate allegiance to the fellow, to the leaders of government, that means, and the highest level of human government, that means to treat your neighbor government as you would want to be treated. In the individual sense, it's to treat your fellow people as you would like to be treated. And in this sense, then we would all become Ethiopian. The word Ethiopian, it comes from Ethiops, which is a mix of some Greek words that means burnt faces. Now Moses stood before the children of Israel, and the children of Israel bore not to see his face because it was radiating with the splendor of God that he had seen up on the Mount Sinai. To be illuminated and to be a light being, like the Bible says. See, a lot of people take the Bible and, you know, they come up with these weird ideas like, we're going to be light beings. Like, I don't know what people think. But to be an illuminated individual who has a burnt face that is radiating truth is enough to be members of this new race. And if your face is radiating with the splendor of Jah, of Yehovah, Yahweh, Yahawashah, Yahuwah, however one wishes to pronounce it, then we would all be Ethiopians, and we would all be working together, therefore we would fulfill our requirement to be a part of the Ethiopian World Federation, which is the center office to the which my personal administration duties are held. The language of the society, Espanol, branching from the Land of Judah Society Incorporated, which is it's a section of the Ethiopian World Federation established by His Imperial Majesty. So, anyone want to talk? And you know what? His Imperial Majesty is a lot more to some of us than to most. When some of us did not grow up with a father. You know, so he fathered us like he fathered many nations in Africa, fulfilling what Abraham was to do, be a father of many nations. You know, centering the Organization of African Union in the capital of Ethiopia, Addis Ababa. His Majesty fathered many nations, and he fathered I and I too. As a matter of fact, without His Imperial Majesty, we are dead, we had no life. And that's a testimony to what it is. You know, for what it is. So it means a lot, you know? And he is actually the exemplary character of how to behave and conduct oneself at the highest level of human government. And then one would know, after studying the history of His Imperial Majesty, would know that it is possible to have leaders that make good decisions, that make the right decisions, that do what is necessary to uphold their position integrally and morally, ethically.
So yes, Brother Alonzo, give thanks for those kind words. If anybody wants to come up and use the mic, just come up and check in with me. I go by the name of DJ Nice Up. I want to respect everyone for coming out today. I want to give respect to Zion every time, and Queen Sheba's, you know, eating authentic Ethiopian food right here. I just want to give thanks to everybody for coming through today. We're going to play some reggae music for you, some conscious reggae music.
How you guys doing? How you guys doing? Praise to the Most High. Praise to the Most High God. All right, my name is Matthew Bali. I'm out of Sacramento, California, right here in our hometown, in our backyard. I'm with a couple organizations that I'm representing today. One is an awareness apparel clothing line. We're raising awareness of human sex trafficking right here in Sacramento, and we do a worldwide team. We're taking a stand against that. of young ladies being exploited. We do outreaches and silent protests and concerts right off of Stockton Boulevard, right here in our backyard. So we're taking a stand against that. And the other organization I represent is called GAP, God Answers Prayers, Gang Awareness and Prevention. We mentor youth who are incarcerated, and we do that to prevent the recidivism. We do that to prevent recidivism, to prevent them from returning back to incarceration. So come holler at me. I'll tell you a little bit more about that if you want to get involved or if you want to know more. Music's a big part of my mentoring. I go inside and rap to the youngsters behind bars, and we get unplugged with a mentor, a positive man and woman of Jah, of the Most High God. So we're looking for more mentors too. All right, I'm gonna be announcing some artists coming up here to bring that fire. Next we got Brother Shaka. Brother Shaka in the house. All right, coming to the stage is Brother Shaka. Give it up for Brother Shaka, please.
Thank you. In Dimonos. Hey, in Dimonis. Ha. All right, what's happening, y'all? All right. Okay, my name is Shaka. Some of you know me as the founding father of the Birthing Project, which is the only black woman maternity child health organization in the country, and has been since 1988. We've delivered over 13,000 babies, and we're in 9 countries and 98 cities. But on the drums over here from Mali, we do have a clinic in Mali. All right? What I do is called edutainment, educational entertainment. So listen to me now, hear me later. All right? Back on up and give a brother room, because I got some knowledge to shake the room. I'm shocking like a boom, straight from the womb. Proud black man from the cradle to the tomb. Now, I'm naughty by nature, but refined by design, but I'm no OG who kick it though grind. So take your time, drop a dime, even though it costs a quarter. If you can't stand the heat, better run for the border. Now, it's not Taco Bell that dope man sells, making life a living hell. Brothers standing me from the bars of a cell. Can't you tell by the smell and the bullshit they sell? And your friends locked up in the joint. That you're being misused, your mind's abused, you playing to lose, so what's your point? Now back in the day around the way, I was rolling down the shore with a 40 in my palm, so cold I couldn't stop. Guess who I saw? Saw myself in a mirror, and as I got nearer, it became clearer. The young brothers were trying to be like me. But what did they see when they looked at me? They saw a fool that thought he was cool, didn't know knowledge was a tool that would let you fool that junk in the box fool that dropped out of school. Now, I've been trying to control you for the undertaker hold you, took the knowledge to enfold you. Don't let your brainwash mold you into less than a man or a woman. Because some of the ladies, they don't understand. They think the treasure chest is under their dress. They think of what they behind. They forgot they got a mind. Hoochie coochie flying. I ain't lying. And I ain't joking, smoking or coking, cracking, smacking, or macking. I'm just backing, straight jacking. All right. I want to ask you a question. My grandmother, my father's side, she raised me, and she was 102 years old when she died here in Sacramento. And she had these sayings, you know, and she sees somebody doing something dumb and stupid. You know, we grew up on a farm. So she say, you know, that fool ain't got as much sense as God gave a goose. Now, you don't think about that, but when I moved to Sacramento with my kids, I bought a farm out here by the airport. And we had geese and ducks and chickens and horses and cows and everything except pigs. And when you looked at the geese, I had about 45 geese that were the big gray geese called Toulouse. Okay, not the Canadian honkers, but the gray geese. And when you looked at the geese, you realized that the geese had a lot of sense. Okay, you knew who was the leader, you know who the goose that would fight. And then I had one goose that was, she was different from the rest. She was a Chinese goose. You know, she was white with a long swan neck and a horned bill. And my kids knew she was a Chinese goose, so they named her Shanghai Lo. Now the rule we had at the farm, if it had a name, it was a pet. If it didn't have a name, it was food. Okay, so every goose had a job. And Shanghai Lo's job was to take care of the little geese. She would walk them down to the creek and she would shade them in the sun, you know, with her wings, and she would fan them, you know, to cool them off. And if a rooster tried to attack one of the little geese, she would fight for it, defend it. So I want to ask you, do we have as much sense as God gave a goose? Now, when you see the geese, you guys have seen geese flying over and you hear them honking, okay? And they flying in that V formation. Well, when you hear them honking, it's not the geese in front that's honking. It's the geese in back that's honking. And they honking to encourage the beaters to keep up their speed. Now, if we got as much sense as God gave us, then we should know when we honk from behind, we should encourage our leaders to keep up their speed, not just criticize them, if we got as much sense as God gave a goose. Now, when a goose is flying lean, when it gets tired, it rotates back in the wing, and another goose takes point, and they continue their journey. Now, if we got as much sense as God gave a goose, then we know we all got different skills. So we all can take turns being a leader at the same time, because we all going in the same direction, if you got as much sense as God gave a goose. Now, when a goose is shot and it falls out of the flock, two birds fall out of that flock and they follow that bird down to the ground. And they stay with that bird until it's either recovered and able to fly or it's dead, and then they join up with another flock and continue their journey. So if we see someone in trouble, if we got as much sense as God gave a goose, then we know we should help each other until we cannot help each other again. So, and finally, you know, finally, when the geese all reach their destination, they do it on the thrust of one another. Because the reason they fly in that V formation is just like car racers do. They go on the drag of one another. It's called coefficiency of drag. So if we got as much sense as God gave a goose, then we know we should get together with people who are like-minded like us, like the brother who is mentoring the kids in incarcerated, if we got as much sense as God gave a goose. Do you?
Yeah, yeah, yeah. I hope I do got that much sense. Maybe more, hopefully more. You know what I'm saying? As they say, just as much, if not more. I find the mic in my hand, so it's a natural thing. I'm like, yeah, let's do this. You pay? Would you just take this device? Ugh, so tired of it. Somebody feel me now. Ooh. Yeah, it's true. Like, whatever you want in life, you got to give it to get it, you know? So even if you have to ask for it, but, you know what I'm saying, your request could be granted because you've been given that. You know, you give respect to get respect. You know what I'm saying? And like the brethren was saying, if we have leaders, then we got to honk them from behind and with respect, not just the criticization and stuff, you know, trying to bring a different vibe and all that good stuff. However, I got my DJ Nice Up the place, and we're just going to do some tracks here. I have an album, by the way. My name is Haiti Benefits. You know what I mean? And I'm a person, like all of us, you know what I mean, searching for my mission on this earth. And I've been in Haiti for the last decade or so, you know, just rediscovering who we are. Anybody who's a second generation Americano, certainly head back to your roots, you know what I'm saying? Be careful though, because you might get stuck, you might fall in love, you know what I'm saying? So that's what happened to me, and I got sucked into the vortex. So I kind of got reincarnated and spit out as Haiti Benefits. So seeing the lives of the people and just the smiles of the people, it grew a lot of compassion in me. So now I kind of dedicate or livicate, because you know, you don't want to dead nothing. But I livicate my I life to benefiting Haiti. And it just so happened I came forward to the States, because we don't come back nowhere. Forward ever, backward never, you know. And I actually found a CD that I had wrote like 10 years ago, well, before I went to Haiti. And I wasn't so inspired for rap as I was as a youth. You know, I was more about, selfless acts, if you would, or some might call it charity. However, I found this CD that I had recorded as a young child. And it was like the Most High saying, okay, so use this CD, use this music, because I never lost the perspective. In my opinion, I still kind of was talking what I was talking 10 years ago. I don't disagree with anything that I heard. So these are maybe a song or two from that CD 10 years ago. Haiti Benefits, Check me out, Instagram, everything, Haiti Benefits. Okay, okay, this was cool. Yeah, this was kind of a club song. Yeah. 20 strong, 40 deep. Strong arm and Bobby Long from the club to the street. We came in Queen of Sheba, 20 strong, 40 deep. Strong arm and Bobby from the club to the street. I came up in the club, 20 strong, 40 deep. Strong arm and Bobby Long from clubs to the street. We came in Queen of Sheba, 20 strong, 40 deep. Strong arm and Bobby from the club to the street. Hey yo, you see me? I came to the club, I left my bling at home. Cause you know I'm strong arm and Bobby before I'm going home. If I'm going home, when I'm going home, I'm sounding like Paco. Hail Mary, bring me home. No, you ain't Biggie. Hallelujah, holla back. Come and see me, cause I'm chillin' right where you at the same time, at the same place, but not necessarily to the same degree. Okay, you see, I carry heat, I'm talking flamethrowers. You carry heat too, but mine's a flamethrower. You see, I smoke tree, you smoke tree too, but it's not OG. Hey, Mr. Me Too. Hell yeah, I got a 40 man crew, so what's 40 times one of these Mr. Me Toos? I gotta snipe one of these Mr. Me Toos and make examples out of Mr. Me Too. Cause we came in Queen of Sheba, 20 strong, 40 deep. Strong arm and Bobby from the strong to the street. We came in Queen of Sheba, 20 strong, 40 deep. Strong arm and Bobby from the club to the street. Yo, flip that. I'm gonna leave y'all on the club vibe too much. Yeah. Man, stop, DJ, you know what to do. Man, you're gonna go over there. You know how to do your job, bro. Okay. Yeah. This song is actually in Creole. As the mother tongue of my homeland, I want to share with y'all just so you can hear a little bit of the language. Yeah, Monsieur le Président, no best way, yo, c'est la vie. Pas un pire, no lie, just show, c'est la vie. Le 2018, no d'arrivée, mais yo, c'est avenir. Pour famille, pour amis, ni pour Haïti. Pas un pire, no lie, just show, c'est la vie. Même l'heure moins soldat, fuck moins jouit la vie. Le 2017 nous t'attend, nous aussi la vie. Mais l'heure nous garde nous ouais, on pile la plie. Devant, devant net, c'est le style ça. Zotobouet, fun, tête, pep, dans vos iguaz. Milité yo là, rendez-vous qui ça. Wap, jouer une réponse dans ancienne histoire. Bouya, ou bien bouyaka. Next thing you know, yon pay he baka. Too much of that abracadabra. Next thing you know, yon pay he draka. Shaka, Zulu then voodoo. Stick to the roots and rent the country. Bum do, nous besoin dignité. Et politicien qui sort de Guinée. Avec yon président, patron, qui pas wow. Pas coup, pas droit. Ni pas Jude, pas Jacques, ni pas Gilles. Ha! Vous tombez dans le mitin, y'a un père dans le Jésus. Monsieur le Président, nous besoin, y'a aussi la vie. Pas un pire, non, I'll translate it, yeah. Mr. President, we need just a little life. Not a lot, no, just a little life. In 2018, we want a little life. In 2017, we waited for the life. But then again, all we saw was no love and no light. That's a little translation, right? Defunct, next. Send us this out, yo. Keep it lit, bro. We ain't gonna hold the people too long. Take three, dog. Yeah, cause it's a language, y'all don't know the language. I'll hold y'all there.
Okay.
Yeah.
We need to get.
Okay, this is a little positive song. I call this one Mortal Kombat. I was a Mortal Kombat fan 10 years ago. And I believe we're in a Mortal Kombat today still. Stand up for your immortality. If rap was combat, I'll have a flawless victory. Mortal Kombat and then applaud the symphony. String theory, hands off, immortally. Peep the elegant universe. Mind, body, spirit is one with equilibrium. Serotonin in my body, Jones in my bones. Not for these hotties, but the Lord Almighty. Haile Selassie, Bunk on their posse. Bunk on their crew, they don't do what we do. Original bad boy,
I said who was you all over the world. I'm one with all people. I understand the difference between the good and evil. The evil is the earth and the good is the heaven. I hope you understand like my man Circle 7. Was hope without faith? Was faith without works? Not a damn thing like Christ with no church. And the church is the wife and the wife be his bride. He's coming back to the earth on the full ride. Scholarship signed by the Most High. Low GPA niggas access denied. If rap was combat, I'll have a flawless victory. Mortal Kombat, applaud the symphony. Shrink every head, nah. Immortally, keep the elegant universe under the sea. Is the glass half full or half empty? Glass half full or half empty? Your glass half full or half empty? Your glass, yeah, yeah, yeah. Mind, body, spirit is one with equilibrium. Mind, body, spirit is one with equilibrium. Mind, body, spirit is one with equilibrium. Serotonin in my body, Jones in my bone. If rap was combat, I have a flawless victory. Mortal combat, applaud the symphony. Strength every head, now immortally. Keep the elegant universe under the sea. Yeah, y'all. Check the elegant universe. I saw a little documentary called String Theory, an elegant universe, having an explanation of the universe in a scientific way. And I thought it was pretty cool, pretty good, but it didn't really add up to what we face and what we have to attain to as Mortal Kombat people competing for our sanctuary as mortals. No, it's more than String Theory. There's no theory you can put on it. Just pure love and devotion to the Most High. No theories involved. But the universe is an elegant place when you learn how she works. Yeah. I don't mean to be all in your face. I just want to bless up and nice up the place like my DJ. Alright. Got a couple more songs maybe later on. If the Most High is willing. Everything is with Jah will. We are passengers in this life. We are not drivers. Just go for the ride. And don't confuse your mind when you see the signs. Woo! Haiti benefits, once again. Haiti is waiting for us. And we're coming towards her. Just check out the site. Check out the documentary. Haiti benefits. Haiti is waiting for us. Please, put five on it. I got five on it. Yay. Thank you guys for your patience, your solitude, your presence, and your dancing feet, because y'all gonna be dancing in a minute here. Hey, the benefits. Ooh, ooh, Queen of Sheba, I tell the cooking.
That's right, Christ in his healing prior action. The character with the accent, yes, I. To Mashiach, Rastafari, and Yeshua HaMashiach, the high priest, but you know. That's from us here. We want to thank everybody for coming out to Black History, making this so beautiful and clear and lovely. Yeah, man, so much energy. I'm trying to stay on point. You know, I'm Caribbean, I'm Haitian, so, you know, I can't blame the whole island, but I do have some time disabilities, but you know what I mean? We can work it out. Yeah, man, let's go with it. So help me introduce a young man from Hearthstone Charter in Oroville, California. We represent Butte County. Yes, I. It's intercounty mental. Everybody, raise up your hand if you're not from the Butte County. We're visiting.
Micah Wick.
No, not yet.
Micah Wick, come over here.
They're going to be performing too. So they're like, oh, it's our turn. Yeah. Thank you so much for supporting Common Unity, Enrichment and Education, Production, Literacy, Art, and Youth. We like to call it the Q Play, because it's time to play. It's time for us to express ourselves and be the young youth in the heart and, you know, learn fire on this. But So speaking of youth, we have a conscious youth by the name of Johnny Arrow. And he's going to share some words with us. Please give him some love. Show him. Let him participate in Black Humanity. And after that, we're going to do, we're going to have the youth do a little wise words of His Majesty from the upcoming generation. And a little bit of words sound power for you. We're going to have some Amharic. Yes, we're going to have some words, some scriptural words with some drums and everything. So be patient. We're getting to that time. We want to thank everyone for coming through. And Johnny Ayers is the last of our open mic. But if anybody wants to get up here before we like start getting into our production, into the Block History production, please feel free to come up. Bless the mic. Bless us with your words and your energy and all that. Give thanks.
Hello. I'm going to be performing a poem that I sort of turned into a rap. It's called False Love.
Sorry.
I hound after women like a pack dog, lonely and slack-jawed, tawdry yet unflawed. Wild accusations follow false validation, digging deeper towards my inner core for lacking inspiration. Rather, I am greeted with false infatuation, which, as we all know, has been played out for ages. Thus, I remain aimless, uncaged and heinous, unthoughtful yet brainless. Romanticism seems completely contagious. False love is painless, and I fucking hate it. Love burned me, I ate it, consumed it in hatred. It left me drained, I am construed as jaded. It's not my fault that romance is outdated. Most lovers feel like they're removed and faded, as if their affection is unworthy or tainted. It always begins, a bloom and elated, only to be replaced by feelings of hatred. I write of this pain without purpose, recite words that are worthless. Absence of meaning, thus I refuse to rehearse it. My sensitivity is used to confuse women into worship. They used to amuse me, only ever on the surface. Inside, I smolder like a forgotten furnace, comatose in earnest to find love and burn it. My flame lies down, I feel myself grinning while reminiscing on something once held as true. Our love was like glue, your eyes were like food. We were the sky, gently losing its hue, fading to black, becoming recluse.
Beautiful youth up here. So this section that we're about to do is the wise mind of His Majesty, spoken from the upcoming generation. And I want to thank the parents and who helped. Yeah, sister, mom, Melissa. Yeah, drum mom, Kaden. Yes, Micah. Oh yeah. The mom, Nicole, just for making it happen and having the youth be part of this aujourd'hui, today, yes, because they're our future. And this is humanity right here in its blessed expression. So come on through, youth, come on in.
It is only with God's will that man can reach his ends. In the Creator is a solid foundation in any civilization. Every young person in the world deserves education, yet mere education without wisdom is to limit experience and what it means to be human. I did this. That is a dead baby.
So yes, can we give it up for the children? Can we give them a hand, please? Yes, blessing they use every time, for real. Speaking on knowledge. Matt, go ahead.
So right now, what we're going to do is do some word sound power with the drummers and some scriptural reading. We're going to have a three parts. This is where Black history begins, and the journey never ends, so this is everybody's expression. So be here with us as we bust through time and space. Exactly. He's like, please get off the plate, okay, get off this plate, okay. So yes, the journey has begun, Black history. Yes, come with you. Come with you, come with me, and I'm just going to get off this mic. Merci. Okay. I think Alonso should explain well, and I will explain this briefly. This is our journey. We're all mixed, and we've been all around this world. And that's what we call it Black history. Because not only have people purposely Black history, but we've been all around this common unity, this ball of earth, this rock, this foundation. And a lot of us, our block and our foundation is love and justice. And that's why we're here. Whatever we call the Creator, Yahweh, Elohim, Abba, whatever. You know what I'm saying? It's in the heart. And we know we're just having a spiritual experience here on this earthly plane. So we're all on this together. So this whole block history is for the healing of our nation. So be with us. We need your energy and your love. So yeah. And maybe Alonso will explain a little more. Deuteronomy 28. Brother Alonso will be reading it in the Amharic. I'm going to break it down three parts. Because this is the true history and the prophecy of why we're here in the West. I don't know, what do you call it, North America? Yes, I. And we're blessed. Yes, I. So we need to take this and spread the message to around the world and exchange with our other brothers and sisters on all four corners. Because we have to remember, we got to rearrange it, right? We ready for this new kingdom. Consciousness. Reality. Israel. Yes, I.
Bless up Black history, you know, it's a mystery, you know. Let your light shine and let it glow. If you got the nappy head or the afro, you know we do, we settle in rain, sleet, or snow. The Most High is the resting place, not that place, that's where I want to go. Deuteronomy, that's from the Bible. Basic instructions before leaving Earth. We're going to give you a play, P-L-A-Y, production literacy, art, and you. From the brethren, sisters, from the heart, from the love. This community can change the world. Yeah, we've come together today, and we must continue to do so. How beautiful we bring our children, our youth. Everybody in the place, nice and it's up with the DJ. Yeah, man, Alonso, what did man say?
Israel hoy, the mamla kachin is the better now. In this time, you have an amla kachin, the exaber next time. Better summer. The ring is the zukhne, the zazune hulu, but at the better summer. Amla kachin exaber kemdrum, akazat hulu like a cup, yatar kahal. Yamla kachin, exaber next time. But the man is the very touch, Ulu, you met full colors, you can use him. Answer the Katama Baruka Ekonale. Bear Shama Baruka Ekonale.
All right, all right. Praise the Most High. We'll get into a little bit of hip-hop and rap. That's what I do. That's the art form that I use to fight. To fight against everything that's anti-God, anti-Jah, anti-truth, anti-love, anti-life. All right, this first song I'm doing right now. What's that? Oh, I messed this whole thing up. Oh, my. We're having a dance? Huh? Oh, okay, I am going to do my thing then. I'm going to do track. I'm going to do track. Okay, Jesus. So, this song I wrote right here, can you give me a moment? This song I wrote right here, I wrote when I was window washing. I was doing a blue collar job, and I quickly hustled up and got this job because my first child was on the way, and I was sleeping on my mama's couch at the time, so I had to get the first job I could take. And the first job I actually got was in a restaurant, and that didn't go so well. Then I was blessed to have this window washing job, and it really was a blessing. My only regret is I didn't have that much time to write songs. So this song right here I actually wrote while I was on the job. I didn't have a beat for it. You know, I was just yearning and thirsty to write a song. So I wrote it while I was working. And it's called Priorities. What I believe my priorities should be. And that's God first, my wife second, my child third, and then my job or hobby fourth. And I believe by putting those in that order, everything will just fall into place, you know, the way it should be, the way it ought to go. So this song is called Priority. Yeah, first things first, B-I-B-L-E, believe in before leaving earth. First things first, believe in before leaving earth. That's foremost and first. Then I got my blue collar on and my white one too. I don't provide for my home and my life ain't true. This hype ain't true and these rhymes ain't true. But let me break it down to a science for you. Yeah, let me break it down to a science for you. First off, Hawk with the rock, Kobe Bryant. Secondly, number two, I'm loving on her like I did me, sacrificially. Thirdly, I'm raising up my team, father to my daughter, training her butt to step out on water. Number four, I'm working by the sweat of my brow, wholeheartedly serving the Lord on my J-O-B. And when I get that money, when I get cash, when I get paid, I take what I made. 10% of my nuggets, chuck it in the bucket. Them curses, I duck it. I take 10% of my nuggets, chuck it in the bucket. Them curses, I duck it. Yes, then I do it all again. But this ain't tradition, spirit and true. Blue collar on. White one too, I don't provide for my home and my life ain't true. This hype ain't true and these rhymes ain't true. But let me break it down to a science for you. Believe in before leaving earth, that's foremost and first. Then I got my blue collar on and my white one too, I don't provide for my home and my life ain't true. This hype ain't true and these rhymes ain't true. But let me break it down. Yeah. Let me break it down to a science for you. Yeah. Let me break it down to a science for you. Yeah. Let me break it down. Number one, the guy who made me. Number two, my beautiful lady. Number three, my precious little baby. Number four, the job that paid me, and I'm praising the Lord. And if that ain't the order, then my life out of order. Number one, the creator who made me. Number two, my beautiful lady. Number three, my precious little baby. Number four, the time that paid me, and I'm praising the Lord. And if that ain't the order, then my life out of order.
truth. But let me break it down to a science for you. Believe in before leaving Earth, that's foremost and first. Then I got my blue collar on and my white one too. I don't provide for my home and my life ain't true. This hype ain't true and these rhymes ain't true.
Alright, alright. That's the order, that's the order. That's what I believe the order is. Alright, this next song I did, God actually blessed me after that window washing job to start making some money off of my craft and my art. So that's how I've been living the last 3 years, is doing music and selling shirts that raise awareness of sex trafficking. So that's what I'm spending my time doing full time. And it's a lot more work than working for someone else. It's a lot more work working for yourself. But it's a lot more of a blessing though. All right, this next song I did with my daughter. Can you bring her up, Grandma? We wrote this song. This is one of my other jobs right here. Come here, Eve. Just like how we practice. So we did this song. I'm gonna see if she's gonna come up. She hasn't had her nap yet today, so you know how that is. It's all those parents out there. So this song is called Everything Is Broke. That's how my daughter said broke. Everything is broke. All right.
Good morning.
Hey. Hey, my song. How you doing? She did this song when she was two.
It's a mic.
She's three and a half now. No, she thought the mic was a marker.
That's a marker.
Say Jesus.
No, don't hit the mic. No, don't. No, baby, don't hit the mic. No. Say Jesus. When she was one, she was hopping on stage with me, no problem. When she became a little more conscious, she's slowly coming back though. Come here, Eve. This is my favorite song right here, listen. 2014, finally had a baby. Dreams of having family, shattered issues with my lady. Considering giving my gift to the world, the church ain't trying to pay me no attention. First time I wrote a rhyme, high in the tension. High off the El Shaddai, focus on his vision. Came a long way, where's my contract extension? Should have been married, but I got too much ambition. Ain't that ecstatic, all I see is people split up. Got a half empty cup, and that really shouldn't be. Cause the Lord filled me up, I mean I'm blessed to breathe. Plus he opened my eyes to see a whole nother day in California. So I hit that 8-0 and I'm heading down the highway to the R.O. Still friends with my lady, so I see my baby still. But Adam still seeing some things and still ill. But I focus on his promises, the only thing that's real. Jesus loved me, this I know. Even when everything around me broke. Sing it, Eve. Sing it, baby girl. Jesus loved me, this I know. Even when everything around me broke. My little precious girl, my little baby Eve. I know things seem broke and they are, but a couple things ain't broke. One, your daddy hope, and two, your daddy paper, cause your daddy working hard to get you milk and diapers. Let me tell you what inspires. It's Jehovah Jireh. Then it was the day I found you on the way. After that it was conviction. Your daddy busted back, working in the kitchen. After never bread, but that really didn't last. The training manager was cussing at your dad. Get that daddy head, so your daddy got mad. And lightweight threatened him. Yes, daddy did sin, and daddy got fired. But later he was hired by a window washing job. His boss was a Christian, a real man of God. And that let daddy know that Jesus always loved us, even though things around us broke. Even when everything around me broke. Sing it, baby girl. Jesus loves me, this I know. Even when. So $12 an hour is what daddy made, and that was okay, I mean, that was alright. But daddy didn't like being away 10 hours a day from his precious little babe, and then getting home with only 1 hour to play, and then doing it again, day after day after day after day. So daddy prayed and prayed and prayed and prayed and prayed. Now daddy on his way, but daddy getting more paid doing what he loved. Music art sharing, the one from above. So all you fathers out there, never give up. Keep doing what you wanna do, excuse me. Keep doing what you're called to do. Let God go before you, put your family second. You gotta love the word for us to give them right direction. And don't believe or see the false misconception. In this fallen world, we're blessed to be stressing. Every trial we go through is a lesson. Right around the corner is your blessing. Jesus loved me, this I know, even when everything around me broke. Jesus loved me, this I know, even when everything around me broke. This next song is called Trappermento. I wrote this song because, like I said, we mentor youth who are incarcerated. So when I was in there sharing to the youth, one of the youth said to me, he said, you know what, when I leave incarceration, I feel like I'm in a trap, because when I leave juvenile hall, I'm in a worse situation than being locked up in here. So I wrote this, that's one of the reasons why I wrote this song. It's called Trappermento. I got some CDs over here too, my new album, Trap Rhythms and Life Rhythms. I'm stuck in a trap, inside, Ramento. Give me that trap and some mento, so I could free my mento and free my kinfo. Turn it up a little bit right there, was good. Freedom's in a trap with misdemeanors and a felony. Give me that trap rhythm. What I'm spitting is real. Am I ever gonna have a house on the hill? Mom and dad never made big bills on love. The money, that's the rival. How in the world do I break the cycle? Around here where I live, my boy, things ain't looking right, y'all. When I look out my window, what do I see, though? Predator. Sexual, turning tricks, pimping hoes, low. Income apartments where I stay, bullet spray. Mother of my C didn't wanna stay, I was trying to put a ring on her finger. Didn't wanna linger here. I just wanna raise my beautiful little baby. But she feared for her safety. And she said, can you really blame me? I say, try to understand. I'm here for a plan, a purpose, a reason. It's just a season's breath I'm breathing. My life ain't my own, but on the real though, can I get a home on a hill in Colorado? Until then, I guess I'm just stuck in a trap, inside, rub mento. Give me that trap, it's a mento, so I could free my mento and free my kinfolk. Give me that trap melody to free those in the trap with misdemeanors and the felonies. I'm stuck in a trap, inside, rub mento. Give me that trap, it's the mento, so I could free my mento and free my kinfolk. Give me that trap melody to free those in the trap with misdemeanors and the felonies. Give me that trap rhythm to free them from the trap within them. We all in the trap if you ain't in the killing sinning. No matter where I'm living, it's a little bit of heaven. It's all about perception, I ain't never in a trap. Life and resurrection, get me out of that. My refuge, my protection, no matter where I'm dwelling. But some of my brethren is failing. No hope for the hole they failing. No hope for the trap they dwelling. But it's all up in our melon. The God I serve is sovereign. Able to solve that topless problem. Able to solve that squabbling problem. Peace into your drama. You and your baby mama. And to the young thug that don't wanna bang, wanna make a change, you ain't never in a trap. You ain't gotta take the back, you take the front door. Answer the call, call on the Lord. The best thing I ever do is snitch on you to the one who took 39 lives in the back. You ain't never in a trap, you ain't gotta take the back. You take the front door, answer the call on the Lord. You ain't never in a trap.
call on the Lord. Stuck in the trap, it's sad. Rub it toe, give me that trap instrument toe, so I could free my mental and free my kinfolk. Give me that trap melody, let's free those in the trap with misdemeanors and the felonies. I'm stuck in a trap, it's sad. Rub it toe, give me that trap instrument toe, so I could free my mental and free my kinfolk. Give me that trap melody, the free those in the trap with misdemeanors and the felonies. Jah is the spirit, and where the spirit of Jah is, there's freedom. So if you got Jah, no matter what situation you're in or circumstance you're in, you're never bound by that situation or circumstance. Stuck in a trap, it's sad, rub it toe. This song right here is called Trap Rhythms and Life Rhythms.
Trap rhythms, life rhythms, what's it gonna be? The choice that you make can either set you free or take you down a road that you don't wanna go. Oh, oh, no. Trap rhythms, life rhythms, what's it gonna be? The choice that you make can either set you free. The choice that you make can either set you free or take you down a road that you don't wanna take you down a road that you don't wanna go. Oh, oh, no.
The way I see it, we all have choices, and the choices that we make can either lead us on to life or can lead us into a trap, a dead end. The Bible says, they that sow to the flesh will of the flesh reap corruption, but they that sow to the spirit will of the spirit reap life everlasting.
Trap rhythms, life rhythms, what's it gonna be? The choice that you make can either set you free or take you down a road that you don't wanna go. Oh, oh, no. Trap rhythms, life rhythms, what's it gonna be? The choice that you make can either set you free or take you down a road that you don't wanna go. Oh, oh, no.
Sacramento City of Kings, new record label has appeared on the scene. His uncle and his cousins, all big G's, thugging, rhyming, no fronting. They live what you seen, trying to do something big in industry. Yet they live what you seen on the news, Fox 40.
The violence started Wednesday with a broad daylight drive-by shooting on East Nichols Avenue in the Fruit Ridge area.
In the South area, got a studio, murder gang area in a video. A message to they rifles, clocks, and pistols, AK and rifles. Waving them in the air to the young boy, daddy wasn't there. He looking up to this, thug-like looking, appealing memories. Raised by a single mother, looking for his masculinity from another. So this is what he wanna be, and this is what he wanna see. But what he don't wanna be is in and out of juvie, in and out of county, doing life in prison. All cause he was influenced by the way his uncle spit and living. No, oh, oh, no.
Trap rhythms, life rhythms, what's it gonna be? The choice that you make can either set you free or take you down a road that you don't wanna go. Oh, oh, no. Trap rhythms, life rhythms, what's it gonna be? The choice that you make can either set you free or take you down a road that you don't wanna go. Oh, oh, no. Trap rhythms, life rhythms, what's it gonna be? The choice that you make can either set you free or take you down.
All right, this is my last one. I'm gonna get up out of here. Where's my dance crew at? I'm gonna end this one on some positive vibrations, all right? Can I do that? The rhythm of my life goes something like this. I do not come back until my money long, until my paper stack right. Lately it's been feeling like when I'm serving them and then I'm always in a famine. But when I'm serving Christ, then I'm always stacked right. I'm jamming, panning verses left and right, obeying my first love, seeking the kingdom from above, never beneath. We are the sheep, we hear the voice, faith and belief, faith and trust. We'll be blessed, trying to feel peace, trying to feel joy, trying to feel love away from us.
rhythm of our life is a bare fruit for Christ. Rhythm of life, rhythm of beat, lay down your life, follow the Christ. Rhythm of life, we are the life, we are the soul. So when we fall down, then we get up. Religious can't understand how we turn up. I'm convinced I'll never burn up. I'm convinced he'll never give up on me. I'm free, I'm so high, and I don't cut trees. No hit to the roster, though. I'm just high, this lyrical spiritual.
Something like this. I pray, I read, I live by Holy Spirit. And when I see that living in, he lived me when I tripped. The rhythm of my life goes something like this. I wake, I eat, I hustle for my paper. And if it ain't enough, I know looking low, things looking rough. God will handle it, I'm blessed and highly favored. I ain't worried about how to sing. Be the bird while we sing. They do not reap our souls, so I'm in the servant. Be so rich, the riches to walk the globe, but the flowers of the field still outdo your fit. So choose this day, who you gonna serve? I'ma serve God, and I'ma serve the word. I'ma serve Christ the King and sing like the birds. I'ma sing like the sparrow, got me high on the sparrow, me high a single. Focus on the gospel, don't get the world. The ways of the Lord are high like Jupiter and Saturn. We make our own plans, but the Lord sets our pattern. To be rich, to be so rich. The rich to watch the flow, but the lilies of the field still outdo your tips. So go, Matthew chapter 6, and live out what we script. About us. The birds don't even reap or sow, yet God still feeds them. The rhythm of my life goes. Alright, thank you for your time. Thank you, Emmanuel. Give it up for this woman right here. She put this all together. And her brother. Give it up for her brother. Here. I got my new album out over here.
I want to give it up to Brenda Balling and Sister Balling right there, Beach Beatrice. Happy newlyweds. Give it to the love, right? This beautiful year. It's Shimatah of Honeymoon Bliss. And he's doing what he got to do. He's out in the field working for the Most High. We want to give thanks to the rhythm of our life. I want to thank everybody for being patient. Now we got the Phoenix. Yeah, we got the Phoenix Dance Company for you. They're getting it set up. We're going back to the original way that our ancestors celebrated and worshiped and gave love and reverence and their heart, space, and chakra. Again, I want to give thanks to everybody who's come up here. Brother Shaka, Brother Balling, Brother Haiti Benefits, again, for opening up the heart space. Aiti Sheli, Aiti Aibobo, Rastafari. Anyways, anyone want to get up here? So I'm going to put it down right now. Phoenix will be entertaining you for the next 30 or so, and then we're going to have some more word sound power reading and the production. Give thanks. Don't let. Thank you.
Thank you.
Sacramento. And my mom's going to talk a little bit while we change our costumes and change our drums.
So for anybody who didn't know before, we are Phoenix Drum and Dance Company, and we are from here in Sacramento. So we do this traditional dance for several reasons. First of all, because it's something that's sort of inbred in us. Secondly, culturally, and apart from everything else, we feel good when we come and dance. So in keeping with the age-old tradition, the storytelling, the grills, the jelly, and we consider ourselves to the jelly, the keepers of the culture. So we start all the way from the beginning, because one day there is this bird, and he was flying in the sky, beautiful bird, and he sang songs to the sun. And this bird was so beautiful that man started chasing it to get the beautiful feathers. So this bird says, "Oh, I can't handle this." And that bird got out there, and believe it or not, just like us, the bird was called the Phoenix. Yes, Phoenix. This sun looked up at the sun, the phoenix looked up at the sun, and they said, "Sun, I want to go to a place where man won't chase me, won't hunt me for my feathers." And the sun said, "Sing songs to me, the only the sun, and I will protect you." But the sun wasn't able to do that. So one day, the bird got up and he flew. He flew over mountains, he flew over oceans, and he came to a place where there were no men. And there the bird sang and flew and sang songs to the sun. But you know, one day the bird got up and tried to stretch a wing, and it was like, "Ooh, that hurt." And then he tried to stretch the other way, and it was like, and then he bent over and he says, "Now I know I'm really getting old." So the bird sang a song to the sun again, but for whatever reason this time, the sun didn't hear the bird. And then the bird says, "I know what I need to do. I need to go back to the place from whence I came." So the bird got up that morning and kind of spread his wings. And then again, he flew over mountains and he flew over valleys and he flew over oceans to the place from which he had come. And there he found the highest mountain. And on top of that mountain, he found the tallest tree. And in that tree, that bird built a nest. And after he had built the nest, I think it was a girl bird. Not really, you know, this is Women's Month, so we'll say it was a girl bird, okay? Yeah, built that nest because we know, that nest, and then sat there and sang songs to the sun. And the sun blazed down, and all the little animals went and hid in caves under rocks. And all the people in Sacramento went into their air-conditioned houses. And it got so hot, and that sun beat down on the bird. And then all of a sudden there was a blaze of light. Whoop! There was and a flame, and it burnt that bird to a crisp. And there was nothing in that nest but a pile of ashes. But in just a little bit, the ashes started to shake and shake and shake. And out of that ashes, there was an egg. And then the egg started to move. And then it cracked. And then a little baby bird came out of the egg. That was the ugliest baby bird you ever saw. You know, just a little feather here and a little feather there. But then that little baby bird started to put out the little wings. In no time, it was the most beautiful red and gold and purple, and it was a brand new phoenix emerging from the ashes. And that phoenix spread its wings and went again over the mountains, over the seas, over the valleys, over the hills, and sang songs to the sun. And we are the children of Phoenix. We, the stories we tell, the songs we sing, the dances we dance, will never die. We are the Phoenix, and our consciousness will live forever. Thank you.
people. Give them a hand, please. Once again. And then we gotta big up all the Congo drummers every time. We're right here at Queen Sheba's Ethiopian restaurant. Authentic food every time. I gotta big up Zion. Gotta big up to everybody for coming through today. All the Congo drums. All the people who spoke inspirational words of poetry. And you know, the rappers and just all forms of music.
Sorry, we're gonna do a Nyabingi drum rhythm now, and we're gonna sing the last part of the Deuteronomy 28. Modified Nyabingi. Nyabingi. So yes, if everyone is familiar with the Rastafari tradition, there is Nyabingi chanting that usually goes on with Proverbs or Psalms or other scriptural words. So we got the crew from Chico running through.
Let me just say something why Deuteronomy is important. There's people in this world who God doesn't care what you care about. There's people in this world that must accept this scripture. It's not for everyone. But most of those people have suffered what we see here because these people don't have a choice. They must accept the God manifested as in the Bible. And that's why Deuteronomy is important, because in the United States of America, most of those people reside, and we see how we have no direction. We entertain, we're great baseball players, basketball players, football players, you know, all the athletic departments, stuff like that, but a lot of these people don't have a choice as to if they would accept the word or not. That's why Deuteronomy is important. Those curses have been manifested, and they won't stop from being manifested, even if it appears as if we're free from them. What have we really won, and what have we really obtained? We've lost ourselves. The revolution's only begun. Amen. Serious about that
bringing in the heartbeat, the ancestral vibe from, you know, when the Most High was speaking to us. That was part of the blessing. So the Most High sometimes speaking words, drums, and dancing. So yes, so part one was the blessing, and here is where the curse sings begin. So yes, we already know the story again, why we're here in the North American territory. So open up your ears and minds and listen to the words and listen to the drum, because this is where it's from. If you won't listen to Yahweh, your Elohim, and won't obey these laws I am giving you today, then all these curses shall come upon you. Curses in the sikhe, curses in the field, curses on your fruits and bread. The curse of barren wombs, curses upon crops, curses upon the fertile of the cattle and flocks. Curses when you come in, curses when you go out. For Yahweh himself will send his personal curse upon you. You will be confused and a failure in everything you do until, at last, you are destroyed because of the sin of forsaking him. He will send disease
among you until you are destroyed from the land, from the face of the land that you are about to enter. Family, listen. From the land that you're about to enter into death. He will send tuberculosis, fever, infection, plague, and war. He will blight your crops, covering you with mildew. All these devastations shall pursue you until you perish. The heavens above you will be as unyielding as bronze, and the earth beneath will be as iron. The land will become as dry as dust for the lack of rain, and the dust storm shall destroy you. Yahweh shall cause you to be defeated by your enemies. You will march out to battle gloriously, but flee before your enemies in utter confusion. You will be tossed to and fro among all the nations of the earth. Your dead bodies will be food to the birds and wild animals, and no one will be there to chase them away.
He will send upon you Egyptian boil, tumors, scurvy, and itch, for none of which will there be a remedy. He will send you madness, blindness, fear, and panic upon you. You shall grope in the bright sunlight, just as the blind man gropes in darkness. You shall not prosper in anything you do. You will be oppressed and robbed continually, and nothing will save you. Someone else will marry your fiancé. Someone else will live in the house you build. Someone else will eat the fruit of the vineyard you plant. Your oxen shall be butchered before your eyes, but you won't get a single bite of the meat. Your donkeys will be driven away as you watch and will never return to you again. Your sheep will be given to your enemies, and there will be no one to protect you. You will watch as your sons and daughters are taken away as slaves. Your heart will break with longing for them, but you will not be able to help them. A foreign nation you have not ever heard of will eat the crops you will have worked so hard to grow. You will always be oppressed and crushed. You will go mad because of all the tragedy you see around you. The Lord will cover you with oil from head to foot. He will exile you and the king you will choose to a nation to which neither you nor your ancestors gave a second thought. And while in exile, you shall worship gods of wood and stone. You will become an object of horror, a proverb, a byword among all the nations, for the Lord will thrust you away. You will sow much but reap little, for the locusts will eat your crops. You will plant vineyards and care for them, but you won't eat the grapes or drink the wine, for worms will destroy the vines. Olive trees will be growing everywhere, but there won't be enough olive oil to anoint yourself. For the trees will drop their fruit before it is matured. Your sons and daughters will be snatched away from you as slaves. The locust shall destroy your trees and vines. Foreigners living among you shall become richer and richer while you become poorer and poorer. They shall lend to you, not you to them. They shall be the head and you shall be the tail.
Pursue and overtake you until you are destroyed, all because you refuse to listen to the Lord your God. All these horrors shall befall you and your descendants as a warning. You will become slaves to your enemies because of your failure to praise God for all that He has given you. The Lord will send your enemies against you, and you will be hungry, thirsty, naked, and in want of everything. A yoke of iron shall be placed around your neck until you are destroyed. The Lord will bring a distant nation against you, swooping down upon you like an eagle, a nation whose language you don't understand, a nation of fierce and angry men who will have no mercy upon young or old. They will eat you out of house and home until your cattle and crops are gone. Your grain, disappear. That nation will lay siege to your cities and knock down your highest walls, the walls you will trust to protect you. You will even eat the flesh of your own sons and daughters in the terrible days of siege that lie ahead. The most tender-hearted man among you will be utterly callous toward his own brother and his beloved wife and his children who are still alive. You will refuse to give them a share of the flesh he is devouring, the flesh of his own children, because he is starving in the midst of the siege of your cities. The most tender and delicate woman among you, the one who would not so much as touch her feet to the ground, will refuse to share with her beloved husband, son, and daughter. She will hide from them the afterbirth and the new baby she has born, so that she herself can eat them. So terrible will be the hunger during the siege and the awful distress caused by the enemies at your gate.
If you refuse to obey all the laws written in this book, thus refusing reverence to the glorious and filthy name of Jehovah, your God, then Jehovah will send perpetual plagues upon you and upon your children. He will bring upon you all the diseases of Egypt that you feared so much, and they shall plague the land. And that is not all. The Lord will bring upon you every sickness and plague therein, even though not mentioned in this book, until you are destroyed. There will be few of you left, though before you are as numerous as stars. All of this if you do not listen to the Lord your God. Just as the Lord has rejoiced over you and has done such wonderful things for you and has multiplied you, so the Lord at that time will rejoice in destroying you, and you shall disappear from the land. For the Lord will scatter you among all the nations from one end of the earth to the other. There you will worship heathen gods that neither you nor your ancestors have known, gods made of wood and stone. There among those nations you will find no rest, but the Lord will hang and will give you trembling hearts, darkness and bodies, wasted from sorrow and fear. Your lives will hang in doubt when you live night and day in fear, and you will have no reason to believe that you will see the morning light. In the morning you will say, oh, what a night we're here. And in the evening you will say, oh, that the morning we're here. You will say this because of the awesome horrors around you. The Lord will send you back to Egypt in ships, a journey I promise you would never need to make again. And there you will offer to sell yourself to any man slave, but no one will want to buy you. Job,
middle passage, and then the emo dance.
Stop.
So thank you. Thank you, Rose.
Don't untie my shoes. Thank you.
Every morning like the sun, you can see me arise and stand 5'6" and weigh 185. Kind of not wide at the shoulder and narrow at the hip. Everybody tell you I don't take no lip. Cold black, that's me. I'm not iced tea, but I'm too cold to hold. Tell you think about life till a toy punk soul. Working every day 9 to 5 for my money. Wanna be legit. Don't take no today to the I to the T. Need education and mother wit. Now there's a future in your past. They don't teach you that in class.
That's right.
That you descended from kings and queens and invented many things. And I bet you know why the kings were insane. They used to try to make me think I was a Negro. Now an African American. Ain't no country by that name, must be the snowman's game, trying to make me feel ashamed, hiding the light that feeds my flame. People dying over colors. I fly my colors every day, they on my ass and in my mind, my words straight up and I don't be blind. Cold down stalking, homeboy talking. My colors are black and I don't do crack, or self-destruction runs on that track. Glorifying pimps, the P-I-M-P. That stands for poor imitation of my people. I don't want you to be a pimp, I want you to be a gangster. Yeah, I want you to be a knowledge gangster, education is slang to. Do you want to hang to see tomorrow? Have joy, not sorrow. You don't have to beg, steal, or borrow. Time waits for no one, but it stands right still for you. If you prepare today for the tomorrow things that will come to you. You see, knowledge is a gun and I'll use it. It's my tool and my weapon, I won't abuse it. Knowledge is a gun that always has ammunition, and when you're well supplied with it on your side, you'll always cheat in your mission. So load up. Stay careful, aim, don't have no shame. Be bold, cause you back it. So when you go for the gold, you can do it with soul, and your future won't be lacking. Super California, Mr. Guest, we have a dosage. You can get it if you win it, and your game will be atrocious.
Don't expect anything. I'm literally just holding my mic. But hi, my name is Miranda Singh. I'm a junior. I live in Oroville. This is my handsome brother in the yellow. Let's give it up for the drummers.
If you need the mic anyways, this is middle passage. So yes, give it up for Issei, Maranatha, Jediah, Micah, the whole family. I want to give it up to Alonso for being patient with me. And Jean and everybody else. Thank you guys for being on the scene and making it happen. So hope you enjoy this production called The Middle Passage, written by Maisha Baton, one of my professors. And yes, please.
I did.
Enjoy.
They stumbled their way through dense forests.
Night rising from thick undergrowth,
shrubs and branches digging at the arms and thighs,
tearing the few remaining covers
from their most private places.
And the air was filled with the lunatic
calling of birds and insects. And the constant moon rose again and again.
Ragged branches of disillusioned trees.
Where are our gods? They cried.
What will become of us?
Of waves and wild calling,
of sailors splashing their way
back
and forth
to the tall ships hovering menacingly at the shore.
What will become of us?
They cried. We who have been gathered up with the dawn and sold amid the clamor and shouts of foreigners drinking palm wine and eating the fruit of the generous mango.
We who have left now like shells on the shore by tides long.
On the ship, the decks were full of them.
Men and women, old and young,
packed tightly and randomly bleeding
under the night sky.
The only veil over their nakedness.
And the iron shackles cut their flesh raw and ripped
into the entrails of their lives. Abandoned. leaves,
and giving themselves to young love,
and paid their sad eye vows
for the privilege of being close through the night.
Perhaps we have died, they say to themselves,
and the distant storm on the wave speaks with an unfamiliar tongue.
The chief stumbles. Immortality. Where are our gods, they scream,
and the distant storm on the wind speaks
with an unfamiliar tongue,
and the chief stumbles and falls before the ship's captain,
begging food and water for the last survivors of his deserted village. And the gods bow down, shuffling and grumbling
at the feet of drunken sailors.
Perhaps with fornication. Their words, not mine.
So you've been through the middle passage. Yes, we've been through that. And this little intermission, this little brief intermission was from the old life to the new on the island. What we're going to introduce right now is the Igbo dance from the College of Embodied Arts. Now this is the and Nefertiti's Dozen, along with other community members. So yes, from Jean Christofferson, again, Nefertiti's Dozen and the College of Embodied Arts. This is the Igbo celebration about the resistance and the fight once we get on the island, because, you know, we don't give up. Right, Igbo? Right, Hebrew? Yes, I.
You don't have to lie on the ground.
Aww. Igbo lele.
Thank you.
Nesta Marley. So we got the mic stand, so I'm the mic stand. Right, you see?
I'd like to say a word first. I was what they call in Kentucky, I was like the black sheep of the family. But I was, say, the light in a very dark family. I don't know how far back, but I'm sure my great-great-grandfather somewhere was in on financing slave trade. I don't doubt it. And I'm so glad to be out of that. John's so good. John's so good. And we are so blinded by education, by colleges and universities. And it's... We don't need it. We need love. And love is all that's coming. We can heal ourselves. If we can't heal the world, the world is just getting worse. But we can heal ourselves. Right.
Now we love. Okay. No more of that.
No more.
No más.
All right, cool. So, you guys ready?
Yeah, we gonna have a little drum live and up after this. But we gonna start with the little calm vibe.
Unsima kayu hani wapo Mini wichoni waka yellow hey ya hey yo Pie pie lila sicha yellow Oya te blechi ya po hey ya hey yo Thank you.
Thank you.
So we give thanks and praise to be here with you tonight. Gonna share some originals that I wrote. So stick with us and we'll make it happen. This mic cord is not long, so I'm gonna have to work it from this angle. Wrapped up all right.
glory unto the Most High.
Yes, sir. Can you guys hear me out there? Yes, sir. You guys can hear me? Good. Yeah.
You guys
are a little loud. This song is called After the Battle because after a whole leap of trials and tribulations, it feels good to get even one victory. So, in the spirit of giving thanks, we're going to tell you about these battles, right?
Thank you.
but bring it out. Give thanks and praise. Now we're going to sing a little song to Mr. Officer. That would be beautiful if you could sing the chord, Bridget. Give thanks.
Thank you.
got a thing to tell the officers around these here parts. And then some, you know what I'm saying? All the police brutality. Nikki V doesn't stand for it. So, yes, if we make a stand, we don't stand for it, then, you know, we'll still be David who slew Goliath in the 21st century. Jah, Rastafari. So now, we're going to do another song. Who am I? It's a more soul-y type song. I hope you enjoy it. These are like all originals that we wrote since last year till now. So, hope you're enjoying it. Hope you're enjoying yourselves and the lovely weather we're having. Spring forward, all that. Thanks for the seasons and the changes. Something you really gotta ask yourself in life is to seek who you are, you know? A lot of people are lying to themselves about who they are. And all in life is about knowing yourself, you know? And that's what Rastafari gets high and really speaks to myself.
Bye. Give thanks, those who are you. I should introduce you to these guys. That is the infamous Creature K. This is Jeffy B on the bass, Dry Bones Malone on the drum check, and Uncle Kevin right here on the keys. Of course, Nikki B, aka Nicole Victory, aka Ghost History. Real love with her, you know what I'm saying? So we got one more tune.
Woo!
And it's called Bombs Away.
Bombs away, bombs away,
Come on. one for Pastor Dude today. Big it up to Mickey B. Gotta give respect to the whole Chico Massive, the whole Eva Massive, you know. Sacramento Massive in the place, always, you know.
In the morning, in brilliant sunshine, the Emperor and the Empress leave the palace. They are on their way to the Jubilee Mass in St. George's Church, where Haile Selassie I was crowned Emperor in 1930.